process planting a pole, inserting a guala inside the excavation. This depth need to be 1.5, but we made it a little bit less just to show the guys exactly what will happen if a pole is not planted the right depth. And we're going to basically plant the composite pole today. That's the pole, it's a 9 meter. Lesser people need it to lift it because the weight is not the same as a wooden pole. So guys, just let's start picking it up. Put it against the guala. You could just hold it for us. There's the guala. And you'll put the pole in there. So the guys will start lifting. Okay, go forward as you guys pick up. Just control it, slide it. Put it in. And if you check the size, this is a 9 meter pole. And the process for guys lifting it is very easy, because normally a wooden pole you use about 8 to 9 people dropping this pole in the hole. At the moment the pole is not standing center, so how will you move this pole to the center line? You'll move it a little bit to the left, press it over until you get your clearance at the bottom, and you bring it over. Bang it a little bit more. Okay, that's it. Bring it until it's lying center. Because your pole needs to be compacted exactly the same size all around. In the real scenario, what you will do here, you can do 1/3 soil, second third will be cement soil mix, and then your last third will be basically normal soil compaction. But we're not going to do it in a practical now, this is just for illustrations. So we're going to fill it full of soil. So we're basically going to put 100 millimeter soil and we're going to compact. So that is our compacting tool. Check the size. The size fit exactly next to the pole in, and you compact all around like that. See what I was talking about? If this pole is not going to be right, you're going to have problems this side. So we need to make sure it's center. Also make sure your soil is got enough moist inside for proper density when you do compaction. Doing roughly 100 millimeters layers and you compact. And make sure it's all around the pole. Some more. Okay, that's fine. Now we can compact. Okay, Mpo, go that side for me. Clemens, go this side for me. Nico, you hold the pole, check the line of sight, make sure the pole is level. Clemens, on pole side, Clemens on your side. Okay, a little bit to the right. Other side. Okay. A little bit too much, a little bit back. That's it. Mpo on your side. Okay. Always measure from two sides. One guy standing on the left hand side and the other guy standing in line of the route. And you need to line the pole from two different directions. Don't use a spirit level because you will not get the right levels. The right way is to do a normal line of sight and you line your pole in a straight position. So we hear the dense compacting. Okay, that's the marker for the right position to plant the pole, but this pole we planted a little bit less just to show the guys in the training sessions what is the level on this specific pole that needs to be 1.5 deep on a 9 meter.
You want to try this one?
Yeah, we want to try it.
You guys can come and try it. We'll try it afterwards. We'll put a ladder on it and we'll climb it. You'll see where this pole will be. Very safe. Without even cement inside, you know. So it's basically 50 mils wide, 150 mils depth to give you some weight on that metal, and 100 mils wide. And then you weld on a nice piece of metal pipe on it, and then you got a nice compacting tool. You hear the density on that compaction, you hear that? Doof. And that's the indication your soil is properly compacted, especially if there's enough moist inside. Now that was a frightening no, no?
No, but I'm confident. I don't mind.
Guys, one thing I want to say also, if you do proper compaction on poles like this, all the soil will go back in at all. If you have soil left after you did compaction, the compaction was not done properly. You need to lift that compacting tool as high as your knee and drop it. So avoid any vegetation and pieces of wood and grass because of the decomposition. Now just compacting that last layer and then we'll work in the rest of the soil. As we were saying, always compact right against the pole to get more density. I think, guys, what we're going to do is we put a ladder quickly up, lash it, and climb one oak. Okay, there we can see the final product nearly. Proper compaction around the pole. With your compact layers, you put all your soil back in this hole. Just sweeping out. Now we're going to climb the same pole. Team is quickly tying the rope. We're going to lash the ladder on this pole that we just planted. Yeah, that's right, you bring it over. Boy, you can bring it over that side.
Okay.
Yeah, you're right, put it where it was. Put it over. Put it over on the outside, bring the rope all around. Con the steps. Shift it up. What's the distance from the pole, did we say?
1.5.
It will depend on your height, so it will be a 4 to 1. So if your height is 6 meters, it will be 1.5 away from the pole. Okay, but let's slide it up quickly. Okay, you need to climb up, then you take it to the second last one. Pull it away, that's it. One more. Okay, that's it. So the distance, just make sure the step is secure at the bottom and not uneven. So normally step on it, press it into the ground or get the right level. That's it. Okay, now we bring the rope over, under. Bring it to the back.
What's
Twice, another one. Always make sure your rope is level. Going over, no, take it out, Clement, go over, go down and then around. That's it. Bring your rope to the side. Slack. Okay, it's perfect. Okay, now you can tie it. That's perfect. Just to show this whole process, there we put it in front. This is how it looks in front. And then it's all the way secured up to the top. So if we're going to pull this ladder, just pull it a little bit. Let's show it's secure. It's not even moving nowhere. And that is lashing, safe working process. You're fitting the safety belt quickly. Now we're going to climb the pole. To indicate that if you plant the pole the right way, you can climb the same day that same pole. You don't need to wait for a pole to set for 2 or 3 days, because it will be secured. Very important, always keep your body as close as possible to the pole until you properly wrap your safety belt or your harness, and then you hook it. Always make sure it's going twice around the pole. You hook it, your hook needs to be hooking from the inside outwards. And make sure you tie that clip so it can't come out. Level your safety belt out, and then you can stand and work on the pole. Sam, hang back for us. That's it. I want to do a long shot. And that's how you plant the pole and work the same day on the same pole. Push it up, pull it back. It's a little bit tricky, but if you get it, it's easy. Pull it over, pull it down. That's it. Thank you.